This week on American Airgunner, Steve Criner is taking us on a hog hunt and showing us what it takes to bag a wild boar with one of today's most powerful air guns. It's time for another airgun review, and we'll see our five remaining contestants shoot some long-range explosives to see who's heading to the next elimination round. It's all happening right now. Hey everybody, we are we're gonna get our boots on here. We're gonna get the dogs ready. We're gonna get everything collared up and vested up. We're gonna round up the posse. We got a bunch of them with us today. We're down here in southern Arkansas. Stay with us. It's gonna get good. And we're gonna set up this bottle right here before we get started. Now usually we'll mount up on a Caldwell lead sled and get everything sighted in, but these hogs are gonna be close range. There's gonna be a lot of dogs around, so we need to be really careful. We need to make sure everything's right. And Dragon Claw's cooking, watch this. It is quiet. There's your pup.
Come over here with me. Yeah, come with me, Clint. We'll be all right. Yeah. He broke. That is, no. Dude, he's 350. He's giant, dude. Hey guys, if we can pull this off, this will be the funnest thing we've ever did. We just gotta file in because if I shoot that hog, I've got my Vaquero, but as soon as I say cut that bulldog, you cut him. Because even if he drops in his tracks, I got my seat last time I was down here. I don't want it again. Because this sucker's big. Trust me, I'll take a hooking before he gets to you. Just trust me, okay? We went in on that big boar, and I mean, he's a giant. For safety precautions, you know, I had Dempsey bring his bulldog in with us. That way I could have Clint over my shoulder and the bulldog right behind me. That way, all I got to do is tell Keith, unsnap him, and then it's game over. He's got a great bulldog. We got in there and we busted him out. He's a big hog. He's going exactly where we came from, which is a mile away from here. We're hoping like heck he don't get into another group of pigs, which these big boars are notorious for. You know, let's go get in the big dogs, have the little ones, and I'm going to skirt out of here. That's what he's thinking. So. We were tying that hog and there's a big black with a bunch of little ones broke and run, so we're gonna try to get these dogs on another one. That's how we do it. We don't kill them all right now. We hobbled that one. We're gonna let him breathe until it's time to clean him.
Don't go anywhere. There's more Steve Criner coming up right after this. American Airgunner is sponsored by Umarex Zeroed In and Pyramyd Air, the world's largest retailer of air guns.
everybody. It's day two. We're still in Arkansas. We're still running around my buddy Justin Kuhn and his cousin Brian and Keith Dempsey. Telling you what, the dogs are working good. We caught some hogs yesterday. Today, we're going to the land of the giants. We're going to kill some big ones. Don't go nowhere. If we can figure out how to get our coffee strong, it's going to be a good day. We got two sets of dogs right now on two different hogs. We'll get a big one right here. I want to kill one with my air rifle. That's what we're trying to do. We're gonna catch a lot today. We're going to kill some of them. We're going to hobble some of them. And
hey, shut up.
Hopefully we kill a big one with the air rifle. So it's going to get exciting.
First drop of the morning, not 30 seconds off the wheelers, 170 yards, we're already bait.
Told y'all we had some dog.
Okay, right here. Ah, come here, come here. As soon as them dogs clear.
Go up there with him.
Cop pig. Back.
Good boys. Go, caught hog. Soot.
Soot.
Yeah, it's probably the mama.
Yeah. What we're gonna do is we're gonna hobble this sow. We're gonna gather these dogs up. We got a real good dog left with a big track, so.
Hey. Big Rick.
I'll wait right here.
Huh? You know, we don't have to kill them all to have a good time. We're down here with some good guys, with some good dogs. We're gonna move the dogs on. They left with a big track. Get on my back, right here.
Head smash, boy. Woo! 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 Hell yeah. Very good, air gun.
It was about to get rough. We see Ivory.
How do I
know? Right here, boys.
Hey, good
job. Good job, Coon. 50 caliber. That first shot right there in the temple like we wanted. Put the hog down. The dog's got on him. Of course, we got Brian Scorch. He's just like a dog. He runs in there, bays on him too, gnaws on his ear a little bit. Justin Coon comes in, catches him. Done hog. We went ahead and shoot him that way. We didn't get nobody's knees cut up. He's still squiggly a little bit. What it's all about right there.
Hey, we're finishing up with our hog hunt down here in Arkansas. I got Keith Dempsey beside me, Brian Scorch, PBR sensation Justin Kuhn, and when I'm out here shooting mean animals like this, whether it be gators, coyotes, I can't do it without them. We're glad you guys joined us here on American Air Gunner TV today. Don't forget, big boars have plenty of power to do what you want, long as you get the education to do it with. With that being said, we'll catch y'all next time. When you mess with us.
Stay tuned, because coming up later in the show, it's our second Air Gunner Challenge. And this challenge has a little bit of a bang.
All right, it's time for our American Air Gunner Trivia, brought to you this year by our friends at Blue Book Publications.
Airguns. Spend less, shoot more. Pyramyd Air.
A legend in innovation and tradition.
These classical and modern masterpieces have sent pellets downrange for over three decades. German engineered to last a lifetime. Quality, power, precision. RWS, the world's finest air rifles.
All right, it's time for a gun review. I'm here with Rick Eutsler, who of course is our resident gun critic. Today we're talking about the Ruger Yukon, 22 caliber break barrel gun. You've had a chance to spend some time with this gun.
Absolutely.
What do you think of it? First of all, visibly, what do you like?
Well, this gun has a lot to offer. First of all, it's lightweight, it looks great. Mm-hmm. It's easy to handle. Umarex has been making guns under the Ruger brand for a while now, so they sort of know what they're doing. And this is the next progression in just another great air gun. It's got a nice raised cheek piece for both if you're right or left-handed shooters. They've got some nice checkering in the stock that makes it stable when you're holding it. It's not going to slip out of your hand, and that's sort of a new feature on this particular style gun. Mm-hmm. They've done some other really nice things that I like. They've added this suppressor on the front, and one of the things that's really important that people are looking for, actually there's a couple things. One, they want it really quiet. Do they want it light? And this gun hits both of those.
You know, the gun is great, and I want people to make sure they know that this is how it comes in the box. You
correct.
Get the scope. We haven't done anything with it. It just comes like this, right?
You know, what I do with the reviews when I do them is I take it right out of the box. Mm-hmm. I'll generally take a gun and I'll shoot it with open sights first if it has it, just to see how it's going to group. Mm-hmm. And then if it comes with a scope, I'll mount the factory scope and start shooting and see how she does. Now this scope is a 3-9 by 32 scope. It's very clear. One of the really important things on this gun that I'm really excited to see, and from what I hear it's going to be a standard, is this gun has a Weaver-based rail.
Just as far as shooting it, as far as breaking the barrel, sighting it, is it easy to shoot, to use?
Umarex has their brand, it's called Reaxis. Mm-hmm. Now this has a gas piston in it, air spring, whatever you want to call it, but essentially instead of a metal spring, mm-hmm. you've got a piston in there that uses compressed gas, and that helps shorten the shooting cycle, so it's much smoother and crisper. And it also makes it easier to shoot because that recoil happens so quickly. The gun really does all it's going to do in a very short span of time.
Let's talk accuracy. I mean, how'd you feel when you got done testing it?
Well, after the break-in period, it was about 50 to 100 shots. Mm-hmm. It settled down and really settled into a nice consistent velocity. And I got some really good groups. And it's funny because I have people ask me, why didn't you try this pellet? Why didn't you try that pellet? Well, I have 70 or 80 different types of 22 caliber pellets. If I'm showing you this pellet worked, it's because the other 79 didn't. I brought some samples here, and you know, that's the kind of groups I was getting at 10 yards. That's a 5-shot group. And that's when you have the right pellet and everything's working, that's what you get. When you have the wrong pellet, you have something that's vastly different. Even though this has got the Reaxis gas ram in it, you still have to use proper technique.
Sure.
If you try and bench rest this without supporting it in your hand, if you don't use the artillery hold, you're not going to get any accuracy,
okay.
regardless of what pellet you use.
This is obviously a considerable difference.
Right.
And that's just from pellet alone.
Just from pellet alone. And what you'll find, and I tell people all the time, buy quality pellets. Make sure you buy garbage in, garbage out, right?
Yeah.
And so one way you can tell, unless you're going to get your micrometer out, your little grain scale, which...
Nobody's going to do that.
Yeah, well, there are people that do that. I don't do that, but there are a lot of people that do.
Sure.
When you're putting in the pellet, if there's an inconsistency between loading, the pressure when you're putting it in, like you pull one out of the tin, you put it in, it goes in easy, you pull one out of the tin, it goes in hard, you can pretty much bet you're not going to have any consistency with that particular batch of pellets.
Okay.
And you'll find that across some brands.
Yeah.
I've been really pleased with the RWS brands. Now, the best pellet I found are these RWS Superdomes.
RWS Superdomes. So yep. Out of all the testing, do you feel like this is the best pellet for this specific gun, the Ruger
right.
Yukon?
And you know, again, that's important to bring out. This particular gun in my shop shot those the best.
Rick, that is a nice gun, man. So tell me this. I mean, you know, this gun can't be the perfect gun. Is there anything you've come across that you're not wild about?
I think the open sights could be a little bit better. They mm-hmm. could work a little bit nicer. And I think that's really about it.
Okay.
For the price point, and you have to be really conscious of the market it's designed for and the price point. This is under $200 retail. It's a great gun. It's just really good.
There you go. Rick Eutsler says, if you need a good gun for varmints, nice little 22, a good common everyday pellet gun, the Ruger Yukon's the way to go, right?
Absolutely.
All right. There you go. Well, that's been it for this gun review. We got a lot more coming up on American Air Gunner. Stay with us. All right, contestants, come on in here, man.
Yeah. Come on.
You guys are looking good this morning. How's everybody feeling?
Wonderful.
Yeah.
That's good. Sarge, you crack me up, man. You never really answer a question, you just yell at me. I like that. All right, guys, so welcome to your second competition of the challenge. This is a little thing we like to call the Big Bang. And the reason we call it the Big Bang is because behind this little target, we have a bag of Tannerite. When you hit this dime-sized target in the sweet spot, you're gonna get a Big Bang. So we're gonna be using the Sam Yang Sumatra. It's a 25 caliber rifle. The Hawk scope here is set at 100 feet. The kicker is the target is 150 feet with an explosive Tannerite backing. They got this dual Iron Bear shooting bench. They can hold it, they can stand, they can rest it here if they want. They kind of have a lot of options. It really is however they feel the most comfortable, but it should go a little something like this. And there you go, my friends. Welcome to the Big Bang. Today we're gonna be using the Sam Yang Sumatra. This is a 25 caliber lever action, 6-round mag. You guys think you can handle this?
Oh,
hell yeah. All right, so we drew names, and going first, again, Sparky.
Yeah.
So guys, let's head back. Sparky, you're up first. Let's get her done.
Yeah.
Get her done. Come on, Sarge, here we go. I love that guy.
PyramidAir.com. Let's see.
That was fast.
Bingo.
Honey, did you do those chores yet?
Chores?
Come on.
Roger, put that drink down. We gotta mow. Chop, chop.
Oh yeah, he's out there showing the grass he's boss.
Pyramyd Air. Big selection, fast shipping, the air gun experts.
Welcome to the Big Bang. We drew names, and going first, again, Sparky.
Woo! Yeah!
Somebody's gotta go first, may as well be me. I already told him before, it don't bother me none. I don't get nervous.
How you feeling?
I'm feeling excellent.
I know how disappointed you were last week when things didn't go how you planned, so.
Yes, that was a bummer.
Here's your chance to make it up, buddy. You had 6 shots.
Oh, I feel like it's only gonna take me 1 shot. Out of the group, when we were practicing, it seemed like everybody was dead on with this gun.
Shooter ready.
.50 extra on a 25 caliber, that's still shooting very flat. That's not cool.
Boom!
Felt great to hit that target and finally see something explode because, you know, Tannerite's an excellent product for long range target shooting.
All right, Sarge, so second competition, man. How you feeling today?
I love long range. Longer the better.
Is this where you feel the most comfortable?
Yes, sir.
Okay, well, you ready? You feeling good?
Always!
Good luck to you.
I'm gonna win. But it's gonna be a good shoot.
Shooter ready.
Ready!
Here we go. All right, a little bit high, about 2 inches high. Third shot miss.
Oh. Darn it.
Well, shoot, man. What happened there?
I could not see the impact, so couldn't adjust.
Well, I'm sorry, brother.
Thanks, sir.
Yeah,
love it. It's one of the things of shooting. Not everything's going to go your way, whether you like it or not.
Mr. Loco's back in the building, and I am more excited than ever, ready to get it cracking, shoot that bullseye, blow stuff up.
All right, Mr. Loco. What's how up? You feeling, buddy?
I'm feeling serious right now.
Yeah?
Yeah, I'm trying to win that money. The naysayers they can kiss my butt. But, you know, let's see. I'm going to prove them wrong today.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Getting ready. Got his hat backwards. First shot is high. High and a little to the right. Second shot, low and to the right.
That's what I'm talking about!
You! That a baby!
How'd that feel? Obviously, that felt good, yeah?
That felt good.
Three shots. Good job. We got a few more shooters, so head back and we'll see you later, all
right? Thank you, man.
You know, I think me being the only girl out here, I think there's a little bit of, you know, I'm a man. I can do this better than you.
How you feeling today?
No pressure.
All right, girl.
Let's do it.
Good luck.
It's a really small target to hit, but we'll see how it goes.
Shooter ready. All right, here we go.
What kind of adjustments did you make going in to hit that on the first shot?
I aimed the sight about an inch up. I was thinking in my head, I was like, I want to hit this first shot. Just, you know, see what happens.
Nailed it!
I did. I don't think they knew I had it in me. So I just pulled the trigger and let her blow.
All right, Bob, so I know we've got you guys over by yourselves. So you don't know what happens, but
right.
What do you think just happened?
What do I think just happened is I think I've gotten set up here. Amanda just shot the first shot.
Good luck to you.
Thank you.
All right, Bob.
I have to pay more attention to the timing. Try to be as meticulous as I was yesterday while not dawdling at it.
Shooter ready.
Ready.
Boom!
My God. My God.
Oh! Well, sir, apparently you do well under pressure. Why are you so surprised?
These guys are some good shooters, and I'm keeping right up with them, and that is just amazing. Hoo-wah! I'm on cloud nine right now, but this isn't the end of it. Another challenge next week.
All right, guys, great competition today. That was fun, huh? First of all, we got to give it up to our one-time shooters, Bob, Amanda. First shot. Yeah. The third person to join you guys who did it in three shots, Mr. Loco. Well done, sir, well done. You guys will be moving on. You'll be safe next week, which means, unfortunately, Sarge, Sparky, you guys next week will be competing in our elimination round. Sparky, I know you're pretty surprised by this, am I right?
Extremely.
And Sarge, I'm not quite sure about you. I feel like you're just trying to get in more trigger time, am I right?
Always.
That is it for this episode of American Air Gunner. Make sure you tune in next week. We have the elimination round of the Air Gunner Challenge. See you next week. Good job, guys. Good job, good job, good job. Yeah.
I see Chris pulling it off. Sparky's a good shot.
Things change like the wind, and it feels great to still be here and not have to go to elimination.
Be honest, it's gonna be a toss-up.
It's the extra trigger time I love.
Coming up next week, I'm back with the TCU Women's Air Rifle Team, where they'll be showing me a thing or two about precision competitions. The Airgun guys are back at the round table, and in the Airgunner Challenge, Sarge and Sparky square off in an American Airgunner classic, the Airgunner Saloon. We'll see you next week.
Mr. Loco, coming straight from the West Coast, you know, the state where they trying to take all our guns away and all that stuff. But you know, I'm here, I'm going hard till the wheels fall off. And if you ain't with it, then you better slap yourself, because that's what it is, man. Mr. Loco, West Coast in the building, representing. I'm out.